Few more can be better. This printer begs for Klipper.
The Ender 3 S1 Pro is the top model of the Ender line. Some parts are really good. If you're looking for a premium 3D printer, this might be it. Especially if you're interested in running Klipper instead of Marlin. Let's see all about this printer, and let's talk about firmware as well. Now, on Geek Detour. Right away, let's take a look inside. Very easy to open. Interesting, it comes with a touchscreen that connects here, but there is a port for a node-style knob display interface as well. It also has a port for a Z-limit switch that came with the printer, but you don't really need to install it. The Senior Touch already does its job. Manual is nice, and if you prefer, the SD card brings a video showing how to assemble the printer. But both were missing a very important step. If the print bed comes loose, wobbly like this, you need to adjust the wheels. Well, it comes with all the tools you need. The gantry came perfect, all set and adjusted. It's a dual Z axis with two stepper motors and timing belt to keep them in sync. This is top notch. The X gantry doesn't fall, it actually holds a lot of weight, and it will always stay perfectly horizontal. Pro tip, when you install the gantry, don't tighten all the four screws at once. Tighten only one side, then bring down the gantry manually. This will push and accommodate the other leg at the exact distance. Now you can tighten the other screws, locking the gantry perfectly trimmed. For the rest, I just followed the instructions. You can assemble it in less than 20 minutes. To level the bed, I did it old school. I first used the assisted leveling to adjust the height on each corner. See? Hard yellow springs that everybody loves. It stays forever, like set and forget. Only then I did the auto leveling that measures the whole bed and saves a mesh that compensates for small variations. Now I'll show you some prints, then I'll tell you everything I liked about this printer, some things that could be better, and we'll talk about firmware. The SD card came with four sample models, pre-sliced. The supports of the Cat were touching the model. I sliced it myself and I got much happier with the result. Of course, you need to print a 3D Benchy, or two, or three. I need to show you, I have a box full of 3D Benches. This might be my best 3D Bench ever. It was also the first time I told the slicer exactly where I wanted the seams. Look. It looks great, doesn't it? So, there are lots of things to love about this printer. LED lights. I know it's not RGB and the printer does not control it. It's just warm white that you flick a switch when you need it. But it's super useful. To me, it's always on. I love the light. Inside the structure is aluminum. You can see if you open it. This whole shell is plastic. It's a nice plastic. It feels sturdy and no sharp corners or protected. Very easy to keep it clean. And it comes with a drawer. Full-size SD cards. This is the way. Micro SD cards are dreadful. The touchscreen is beautiful and fun to use, but the interface, I don't think it's confusing, but this interface shows less information than the old Ender's LCDs, and less menu options as well. For example, I had to plug my computer and use a protoface to do a PID auto-tune. And if you want to disable power loss recovery, like I showed in my last video, you also need to do it with a computer or with G-code files. The print bed has heat insulation underneath. It's a magnetic bed and it comes with my favorite print surface, textured PEI on a spring steel sheet. Prints basically pop out when it cools down and you can change plates very easily. The Y motor has a sticker, hot, and at least on mine it feels scary hot. The X motor feels normal hot, the two Z motors were just warm, and the extruder motor always felt cold. Hands down, the best thing is the Sprite Extruder. Everything here is functional, all exposed. It's so simple to install. Cable management is a dream. On the S1 Pro, the hot end is all metal, so it can print high-temperature materials. It's true, there is only one part cooling fan, but to my surprise, cooling is very good. Here is a calibration cat, and this part of the tail is always a challenge, just like the bowl of the Benchy. If cooling is not good, it deforms. But the Sprite has plenty of cooling. The lever of the extruder also feels right, and it's very fast to change filament. Creality also sells the Sprite extruder as a kit. It comes with a flat cable and the metal carriage. I am seriously thinking on upgrading my old Ender 3 Pro with one of these. I totally love it. And this is the filament sensor. Inserting the filament feels quite smooth. Let's look inside. There is an optical switch, but I'm not sure it can detect if the filament stops moving like a gem or if the filament breaks after the sensor. Let me hook an oscilloscope. And yeah, it only detects if filament is there or not. It doesn't look for movement. So if filament breaks anywhere here, it won't notice. It should stop. But it will detect when your spool ends. It pauses the print and waits for you. But there is no alarm, no beep. I suppose it could be enabled on firmware. The firmware is Marlin. It is open source, but Creality left a few important things out. Linear advance could make the corners even sharper, but it's not enabled. I use filament change all the time to mark where I want the printer to pause for me to change colors. I tested it a few times, but I don't know why. It paused, the print had moved away, but it didn't wait for me. It started purging and got back printing. And yes, I updated the firmware to the latest official Creality release, both on the printer and on the touchscreen. So firmware can be better. And here is the deal. If you want to keep using Marlin with advanced features, you need to compile Marlin yourself or use releases from the community. Installing Klipper used to be a difficult task, and buying a Raspberry Pi became super expensive. So Creality launched a very interesting new product, the Sonic Pad. It's written here, CPU T800.
I'll be back.
This thing comes running Klipper. It prepares your printer to run Klipper. And it has a 7-inch screen. It has Wi-Fi and even comes with the sensor for input shaping. I'm showing this to you because the Ender 3 S1 Pro is a premium printer. It prints super well, but it comes with a less than ideal compilation of Marlin. I could spend time compiling Marlin myself, tuning it to my needs, and make videos about that. But life is short. Klipper is about to become mainstream. This printer begs for Klipper, and it's here, easier than ever. If you buy an Ender 3 S1 Pro, you should check this Sonic Pad too. It's Klipper, on a beautiful screen, cheaper than a Raspberry Pi 4. 3D printing is changing again, and I thank you so much for watching to the end.